Abramek kłania się wszystkim fanklubowiczom z Lublina, Polski i z całego świata. Zmierzam w tym momencie na lotnisko Modlin pod Warszawę, aby wsiąść do samolotu i polecieć do Włoszech, a konkretnie do Rzymu, gdzie spotkam się z Luigi Lupollo, prezesem włoskiego, rzymskiego fanklubu zespołu The Beatles. To oni będą także głównymi bohaterami tego filmu. Zapraszam serdecznie do obejrzenia mojego reportażu. Pozdrawiam. Oh, I can't sleep at night, but just the same, I never weep at night, I call your name.
Koloseum. Pogoda jest prima sort. Jesteśmy na najniższym levelu. Póki co pobyt wiem, że jest udany i ja to wiem, że będzie. A jutro wielkie spotkanie. Za niedługo głębsza relacja. Nie będzie dosyć związane z naszym fanklubem, ale no ja muszę, ja osobiście muszę. Jesteśmy teraz tak jakby w centrum pewnego świata. Mówię tu o kościele katolickim oczywiście, o siedzibie papieży. Weszliśmy trochę z innej strony. Apartamenty papieskie. Te cztery okna u góry. Tu byli. Tu grali. Tu śpiewali to dwa razy.
Milano, Genoa e Roma. Is it in Italian language and in English?
Oh, English, good.
You can read very easy. And the pictures in the book are very, very rare, very rare.
Photos.
Look, these glasses, I have these glasses.
Do you have it?
My own.
The same?
Yes.
Unbelievable.
Ciebie też nagrywać?
Co?
Ciebie też nagrywać?
Tak, trochę mnie, trochę pana.
Dobra.
Luigi pokazuje nam w tym momencie książkę swojego autorstwa.
w której zawarł bardzo rzadkie fotografie z pobytu Beatlesów w 65 roku w Rzymie i w innych miastach. Między innymi Milan i jeszcze tam był inna. O, to jest właśnie fronton kina, w którym się znajdowaliśmy.
Look, this is the mother and the father of George Harrison.
Ah, the parents of George Harrison.
The parents of George Harrison. They stay in Rome when the Beatles played in Rome. In the Parco dei Principi, Hotel Parco dei Principi.
They was there.
Yeah. Uh-huh. This is a conference in the Parco dei Principi, a press conference.
Yes.
And the Hotel Parco dei Principi. And, the Beatles facial of the stamp. This girl was the first Italian secretary of the official Beatles fan club.
Is your friend?
This, yes. Uh-huh. He's the actual president, honorary president of the fan club.
You don't know, you're not a president?
Yes, I am the president. Uh-huh. She is the honorary president.
Ah.
Honorary president. The stem? Honorary president.
Uh-huh.
President honorario.
Uh-huh. Rozumiem.
President...
Fan klubu.
Tak, ogólny.
Ogólny prezydent na Włochy. What is her name?
Rossana Lanfiuti.
Rossana Lanfiuti.
Aha. Rossana Lanfiuti.
Oh.
Her home is here.
This bar?
No, in the home. The corner of this...
Za rogiem, ona mieszka tu za rogiem.
Aha.
Biedelinski.
She is in Rome?
Biedelinski.
She is in Rome?
Si.
Tutaj za rogiem mieszka.
He was in cinema? He will be in cinema?
I don't know. I don't think next Friday. Mm-hmm. This boy bring the health of children.
What, an accident?
Yeah. No, è rumore, cappella giù l'erba sul palco dell'Adriano.
Ten chłopak ukradł czapkę
Johnowi.
Tak, w trakcie koncertu.
Aha.
Questo era l'ingresso dell'Adriano.
Quella.
Entrance. Se fare un'immagine tipo Fellini, no? Con le suore che uh-huh. passano al cinema, no? Queste qua.
Aha, to jest zdjęcie właśnie, tu jest ten kino. No i tutaj właśnie przychodzą ludzie przed tym kinem.
Fellini.
No, tak jak Fellini.
Fuori, questo è fuori del Parco dei Principi, all'hotel Parco dei Principi.
Aha, uh-huh, questo hotel.
I fan fuori del Parco dei Principi.
Są fani, którzy czekają na nich.
Na ciebie się.
Lubię. Poche persone.
Qui. This is viewers, yeah?
Yes.
He's here. Mm. We are sitting here.
Yes. Yeah. Not much people.
My gosh.
I know this boy.
It's you.
Yes.
It's you.
Is a member.
Nie, to nie jest on. On zna tego chłopaka.
Aha, your friend.
Is a member of a club.
Aha.
this actress.
Actress.
Famous actress.
Yeah, yeah.
Is Anna Magnani. Anna Magnani won two Oscars.
Two Oscars.
Two Oscars. Uh-huh. Anna Magnani. This is another actress, Italian actress, it's Marisa Merlini.
Mm-hmm.
This is Peppino Di Capri, an Italian singer. They played before the Beatles in Adriano.
Mm-hmm. Supporting.
dreams. This is a scientist. This is Margherita Hack. Astronoma, come si dice? Astronoma?
No, gwiazdy.
No, astronomem jest. Astronom.
Yes, Margherita. Another actress is Valeria Ciangottini.
Beautiful.
Valeria Ciangottini. Another actress, Catherine Spack. Catherine Spack.
Catherine Spack.
Is Belgian.
Belgia.
Belgia. In
Belgium.
Ever in Rome.
And that famous people was in their concert.
Yes.
Ooh.
Yes. In the last concert. In the last concert in the evening when was sold out. A lot of people, famous people, actress, journalist, singers. This is the car.
The car. After?
The car that the Beatles are part of the hotel after the theater. Huh? Little car. The tickets, color.
Oh, a lot of.
This is all the tickets. The poster, original poster.
Mm-hmm.
And the promotional card. The program. Promotional card with the first 4 LP. This is the shirt. And the to be in Italy, and the two
labels.
The first was red, and after black.
Parlophone.
Mm-hmm.
Parlophone without E and the N?
Without E.
Without.
In Italy, without E.
Ah, Parlophone mm-hmm. without.
Parlophone. And the Simbico. Yes.
Beautiful.
For you?
Oh, dedication. Thank you so much.
No, pokaż się.
Autograf autora książki Luigiego. Alberto Durazzi is your friend.
Alberto Durazzi is the photographer.
Ah, photographer.
The song. The song of the photographer. That the song.
Proszę bardzo.
To jest Genowa.
Genowa. To są trzy miasta, gdzie Beatlesi zagrali w roku 65. Dwa występy tutaj, tam gdzie byliśmy, w Teatrze Adriana w Rzymie, a wcześniej jeszcze po jednym w Milanie i w Genowie. Książka dwujęzyczna in two languages. Po włosku i po angielsku. Także każdy może przeczytać. Także niesamowita gratka. So, thank you. So.
In Milano they played in the Velodromo di Borelli. It's a place where play the bicycle. Velodromo, mm-hmm. bicycle, velodromo. Velodromo. Mm-hmm. In time in Genova they played at Palasport.
Okay, so. Mm-hmm. Very pretty. And this is in normal selling, right?
Yes.
From the website on the in the shops?
Yes.
Okay. So I heard so you're very big fan and collector of the records, right?
I have a great collector.
Great, I heard.
I have about 3,000, 4,000 records from the Beatles.
Aha. But only vinyls, right?
Italian edition.
Aha.
Spanish edition, French edition, English edition, American edition, and Polish.
Polish.
Only the
AP from Congress.
Only
that. Yeah. And do you know it? Do you have it?
No,
it's not. Mm-hmm. It's yours.
This is a Polish edition.
Yeah.
This is the collection like the Beatles 62, 66.
Yes, but the shortest. Shortest. Yes, short. Only
yes,
one disc.
Yes. Mm-hmm. This is Polish edition.
No, I think international.
Uh-huh.
I don't know.
I don't know it.
I think this is unofficial, and this is great.
Unofficial.
No, unofficial. Non-remastered. None.
Okay.
From the 80s, I think.
Okay.
It's for you.
Oh.
2 volumes.
It is free.
For
thank
free,
you.
Yeah.
No,
this is a special Japanese edition of Hey Jude collection for viewing.
Uh-huh.
You know, Obi.
Obi, yes.
Yes. Track list, set list with the Japanese.
Yes. Japanese language.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Vinyl sleeve.
Yes.
And CD.
Oh, very nice. Very nice. Yeah. Very nice. It's the same 90. Of the vinyl.
Yeah.
The same.
Apple.
Mm-hmm. So.
Some collectors say to me this is a Russian copy.
Uh-huh.
Maybe. I'm very excited for that.
When I went in Russia, I bought a lot of LP in Russian edition. In St. Petersburg, in Prospektiva Nevsky, no? But in Warsaw I don't found nothing of the Beatles.
Where?
Warsaw. I don't found. Didn't found nothing.
Don't you know? Don't you know any shops?
Yes, but in buying nothing.
Nothing.
No.
I know a few shops with.
I don't remember now.
So and what about
only in Russia, yeah.
And what about very closing Ringo Starr show in Rome? Will you there?
11.
Yes. 11.
I have the VIP ticket.
You have ticket.
The VIP ticket.
A map in Europe with the Beatles places, streets.
We're playing.
For example, this. And Italy is Brescia and Rome.
Grazie.
Beatles fan clubs. Your is right there. Pepperland is there.
Teatro Brescia.
That's for you, of course.
You.
And copy for another member. Oh. And our paper. One on the half of year. Materials from the meetings. This is a title.
È la fanzine?
È il loro giornale.
Every month or every 2 months?
2 times on year.
Ah, 2 times.
2 times on the. This is from March, and then this year will be in October.
Our fanzine 3 times. Yes.
Three. Two.
Every four months.
Uh-huh. Okay. Everything is on Polish, but I can take you a summary what is here.
Uh-huh.
So on the first side is an article about the created a Beatles city between a few countries. Poland, Hungary, Ukraine.
Ukraine.
Yes.
How many fanzine have you published until now?
Ile tych takich
nakład gazety?
Ile numerów już? już napisaliście chyba, mu chodzi.
We are a reactivated group from 2015, because first was from 1982 to 1999, mm-hmm. eight years. Mm-hmm. And now, after 25 years, we are reactivated.
Yeah, yeah. Huh?
The song of the early.
But this is the first two, please.
No. I think this is a fourth or five? Okay. Five edition?
Okay. Już tego było, nie?
This is our president. Oh. This is our actual president, Krzysztof mm-hmm. Stanisław Werner, Christopher Stanley Werner, his nickname, his father, Krzysztof Jan, Christopher John, that ambassador from Ukraine of the Beatles Story Museum, mm-hmm. Sergei Radchenko, the chief, the boss of the Eger Road mm-hmm. Museum on Wenger. Beatles Museum.
But this museum is in Lublin, no?
No. Eger, Hungary.
Hungary.
Węgry.
Budapest.
Very close Budapest. Very close. His name is Gabor Peterti. He was on last year.
He's the president of the Hungary Beatles Museum.
I don't know where he's there. I mean, boss of the museum. The founder.
Ah.
Founder.
Okay.
Our presence. In this article I said about the creation a special union between Ukraine, Poland and Hungary, a special Beatles center of the few cooperation.
Michael Kleber was dream with a Spanish fan club. And Cuba fan club.
From Cuba?
From Cuba.
Ooh, international. Like
I know the president of the Beatles fan club of Cuba. Her name is Yolanda. Mm-hmm. Yolanda Valdez mm-hmm. is the president of Cuba fan club. Do you know that in La Habana there is a statue of John Lennon?
Yes.
Do you know?
I know, of course. A summary of our first 2 years after reactivation. Mm-hmm. A small news about the nomination of Ringo Starr to serve.
Yes.
A special honor.
Yes.
From Prince William.
Yes.
Oh, it's me. Oh. Our president, young Christopher, his father. Our cooperation is women and a very famous journalist music Piotr Metz from Polish radio. He's the biggest fan of the Beatles in Poland.
Musical.
Yes. Radio. See. Mm-hmm. Okay. Because this is.
This is
Krakow.
Our event. Your event.
Krakow. We was a co-writer, co-organization about the orchestral concert. The Polish cover band, The Postman, played with orchestra.
Good.
Yeah, The Postman.
She played good.
Yeah, they have a glasses and original guitar.
The same instruments, the same guitar, the same
that Rickenbackers, Gibsons,
Hofners. Yeah. Yes.
And our fan club, me, my friends from Polish, Marta, he will be on Ringo concert. Beata, our PR coordination director, Darek, Dariusz, Małgorzata, Margaret i Grażyna. He writes a lot of good poems about the Beatles.
Okay.
He is very, very fun until 50 years. What's next? Another article of present. President? Dlaczego Yoko Ono, czyli o wyborze kandydata?
What's it mean?
Ah, why Yoko Ono? This is, I'm sorry, this is article wrote by Grażyna. She is it? About the nomination Yoko Ono to Lech Wałęsa Award for making peace around the world. And this is it. And unfortunately, he was not nominated.
Okay.
Just you know who? Ah, the members of the strike in Maidan on Ukraine mm-hmm. during a war.
our president in the Sandra Pepper suits. It was after, this is a castle, royal castle in Lublin.
Lublin,
yes. It was after a special event. Mm-hmm. The heat of the plate. Sergeant Pepper song, the first song, mm-hmm. and Guinness. Mm-hmm. Guinness, the longest version, the longest playing in the history. Guinness, record of Guinness.
I see.
They was there.
How many?
How long? After over 7 minutes.
What?
Over 7 minutes.
Seven?
Powyżej 7 minut grali.
Minut.
Poems of Grażyna. Julia Ludwikowska, our member, he's a painter. And
nice, very nice.
No, because very soon on the autumn will be released a special book of the Ringo with his photographs. Don't you know?
Yeah.
So
now is the third book of the Ringo.
Mm-hmm. Biografia?
Yeah, no,
for
the third book.
Yes, there is it. There is it. Our president is a worker in the university, Marii Curie Skłodowskiej Lublin University. And he last time organized a special conference about the political music.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. That ambassador was there too. And it's a poster. And a special award for activity during a jamboree. Hunter Davis book.
Davis.
Yeah.
Yes.
And our numbers of bank.
This is the address.
Evidence and address, tak.
Address.
No address. This is an evidential number.
No. This is the last?
Yeah, this is a few ten. Mm-hmm. Few releases of the same press.
Okay.
For a souvenir for you, of course.
Thank you. And is your ticket in English?
Ticket? Mm-hmm. Would you like to go to Lublin?
I got a tanker war. We should start the
Oh, our history.
This one player better departed was in the house with Kudrakov. How did weather in Chesko Bis Lublin. 69? It's very hard in the socialist period. It was very hard for the fan club during the socialist period, o no? C'era censura per anche il periodo socialista per il fan club, per la musica dei Beatles.
Było, Boże, nie wiem jak to po polsku powiedzieć, że w trakcie socjalizacji...
Jak się komuna kończyła?
Tak.
Była...
Fan kluby miały... Może nie wiem jak to po polsku jest... Cenzura?
Cenzura, yes. We have problems with this. We have a lot of problems with communism. And the newest... jak powiedzieć... No, jakby takie nowe reguły wprowadzone po zakończeniu komunizmu jakby nie podlegały, jakby zniweczyły, zakończyły działalność. Musieliśmy się zabrać.
Aha, ci sono entrate delle regole dopo il comunismo che hanno costringevano lo sciogliersi dei
Ma perché io so che in Russia era tutto underground, nel senso non era permesso di riunirsi, di suonare. Io c'ho tutti abbastanza di nascosto, capito, in Russia. Non so se in Polonia era lo stesso.
Mówi, że on wiedział, że w Rosji właśnie było zabronione. zabronione spotkania, no i pytał się, czy to właśnie też w Polsce też tak było, czy tylko w Rosji.
In Russia was harder. In Polish, I think if somebody was clever, they could do it without the problem. Just you had to make a lot of idea to do it without the problems.
Sure.
And how many members will be on cinema?
Usultan.
Nie wiadomo.
Ah, right, the members.
Members of the fan group, your fan group.
10, 15.
Oh.
But the cinema is sold out.
And the tickets is for free, yeah, right?
Yes.
I'm very excited for that.
Is it the only break room?
Yeah, only one.
The only one.
I was
room, one in Rome and one in Mina. In Mina, there is the other fan club. Mm-hmm. Okay, that you brought here. The other fan club in Milano.
There is only two in Italy, right? Mm-hmm. And any participation, cooperation between?
No.
Are you enemies?
No, but the president of this fan club, mm-hmm. The activity, mm-hmm. not for him, is your job. No.
Ah, sorry.
No.
In Polish are three fan clubs. No, two fan clubs, but 1 hour, but only authorized by the Beatles Story Museum, on only hour. Mm-hmm. And there is one very friendly, Nowa Sól, created by Robert Lipiński, mm-hmm. Our good friend, and Kielce. But Kielce, we don't have a contact. There is no a fan club, just a group of the... fans, just group, not fan club, just group of the fans.
In Poland, the three fan clubs?
Two.
There are two fan clubs.
Yeah. Formally, two. Uh-huh. Unofficial, three. Mm-hmm. Two, for sure.
But in the world, there is an official fan club. There is. Mm-hmm. In all over the world, there is. Because the official fan club finished in 73. 1973.
I saw it on
the official fan club of the Beatles. After this date, only fan club.
I saw
the enthusiasm of the fan.
Yes, I saw that information on your website. I just wanted to ask you about that date. What happened in 1973?
Closed. The fan club closed.
Any reason?
Frida Kelly, the secretary, closed the official fan club. The last fanzine was in 1970, mm-hmm. when the Beatles
split up.
Yeah. And in Italy, until 73, the official fan, Italian Beatles, official fan club. But after, my fan club named the official Beatles fan club Pepper, because an origin was named the Beatles fan club Pepperland. The official was after. Because my fan club is
złączyli się.
Cooperation
with the fan club of Rossana Lanfilibandi, the first secretary of the official Beatles fan club. She was very fun to fan club.
Yes, very good.
For this thing. My fan club is named the official Beatles fan club Pepperland for this team.
Any contacts with past Beatles? Any meetings with Ringo of Paul?
Yes, I made a question. I made a question to Paul McCartney. to Ringo.
Where?
Paul McCartney in 2001, when he went in Italy, to present Wingspan.
Wingspan, the compilation.
Do you remember Wingspan? This was a press conference in Milan. My review presentò to this conference. And I made two questions to Paul McCartney. The first was, this is true, that in Beatles anthology, in Beatles anthology book, the notice that when it, when they played in Italy, didn't pay. They tour. And Paul told me, I don't know what this thing.
He didn't know.
But if this thing is true, the money, I want the money now. And the second question was how I was, how was his job with Barry Crowe. Is the girl is the manager of the Foo Fighters. He worked with the girl, no? But the translator, don't understand. And Ringo Starr, I met Ringo Starr in Monte Carlo.
In 1998.
He played the Sporting Day of Monte Carlo with Jack Bruce on bass.
Jack Bruce.
Jack Bruce.
From Cream.
Yes. Gary Brugger on
keyboard.
Keyboard. And, Nils Loughlin with drums and Peter Frampton with guitar.
All star band.
Beautiful concert.
All star band.
Beautiful concert. Beautiful. Gary Brooker played a Ryder Shell of Pair.
Wait, a Ryder Shell of Pair.
Jack Bruce played White Room of Green. Peter Frampton his songs. I met Paul, I met Ringo. Prima che iniziato, prima.
Zanim zaczął.
Prima del concerto.
Before concert.
Yes. I met Ringo, no? And I again to Raro, Ringo, I brought Raro. And on the cover, it was on his photo, and hand with rings.
Rings, yeah,
Ringo,
a lot of.
Ringo told, hockey rings, beautiful rings.
How much time your meeting was, duration? How much time you?
10 minutes.
Just 10 minutes, oh, very long.
No, no, very fast. Rings, beautiful rings. I don't remember this rings. signing the venue. He signed also the butcher cover. I was in the butcher cover. But you are on Lego collector? Yes. insomma. Molto simpatico. Sì.
Oh, beautiful stories. Dla niewtajemniczonych powiem, że kolega Luigi dwa razy spotkał się.
Two times.
Two meetings with the Beatles. Dwa razy spotkał się oddzielnie, raz z Polem. Zadał mu dwa pytania na konferencji prasowej w 2001 roku, kiedy była promocja składanki Wingspan. I drugi raz w 98 roku podczas koncertu All Star Band spotkał się z Ringo Starrem. Spotkanie trwało 10 minut i opowiadali sobie o jego pierścionkach.
Także na 10 minut to jest bardzo dużo, muszę powiedzieć, i dałbym wszystko. Tak samo my wszyscy dalibyśmy sobie poucinać ręce, żeby spotkać The Beatles.
We had our special guest in our events, Billy Preston.
Billy Preston.
Billy Preston. In 1998, here in Rome, and two times costume. Two times. The first time in Rimini, and the second time in Florence, last year, September last year.
Gośćmi specjalnymi fan klubu był ostatnio dwukrotnie Klaus Wurman i w 1998 roku wybitny klawiszowiec udzielający się na albumie Let It Be, Billy Preston.
I met also Yoko Ono.
Luigi spotkał też Yoko Ono, po prostu no, niesamowite.
Yes. She did a show here in Rome of a lot of memorabilia of Lennon in Rome. And in that occasion I met Yoko Ono, a person very, very understanding, you know?
Very shy woman? What is your opinion about his activity? Because activity of peace is very good, but many fans tell where Yoko Ono is main reason of the Beatles split up.
No, I don't agree.
You don't agree?
No. Because at last the Beatles had a great personality. Each Beatle have a great personality and stay in a group for a day was a problem at the end. George had a lot of material that when the Beatles split, he made a triple album. For me, Ophir Must Pass is the best album of the Beatles solo.
Yes.
It's the best
for me. Right. This is my opinion too, the same.
I think only one. Lot of the songs of Ophir Must Pass could stay in the Romeo of the Beatles, but for contract, George, only two songs for one LP of the Beatles. And the personality of George era very strong, very strong in the Beatles.
Yes.
This is one reason because the Beatles split. George was the first that split the Beatles.
He was the first member?
For the first, they split the Beatles. Because he left the Beatles when Yoko stayed in the
studio.
In the studio. He split the Beatles.
Yes.
John
returned after 4 years.
Wanted the Eric Clapton in substitution of George. No?
Yes, there is a very special moment in the TV movie, and this is recorded on audio.
Yes.
And go where?
Yes.
Does that? Sprawa wygląda w ten sposób, że
Yoko nie na kapsa, nie na sportowym bilansie.
Mówi, że Yoko to nie jest powodem
rozpadu The Beatles. Tak. Luigi w żaden sposób nie uważa, że to Yoko przyczyniła się do rozpadu The Beatles, ale uważa, podobnie jak ja i bardzo wielu fanów, że album solowy George'a Harrisona All Things Must Pass jest najlepszym albumem solowym Beatlesów, jaki kiedykolwiek został nagrany po ich rozpadzie.
Also for you.
Excuse me?
Also for you.
Also for me,
yes.
Yeah. I have that remaster from 2001 with the colorful sleeve. Mm-hmm. The best version. Yes. I don't have gramophone.
Cloud9.
Cloud9.
It's a very, very good album.
Produced by Jeff Lynne. I love ELO too.
in September, yes. Next September, in 15th September, I will go to Copenhagen to see Jeff Lee.
Really? You was on the concert?
Jeff Lee, have you seen the concert of Jeff Lee at Wembley Stadium? The video.
Let's see it. Ah, video. Aha. Uh-huh.
Have you seen it?
Yes, I see.
The fans.
Our fans. Many members of our fan club want
to play the Enrique.
Yes.
Enrique. Mm-hmm. In honor of George.
Yes, he will play in Berlin in September.
Yes.
But he did not was he didn't was in Poland. Never. Hmm? Jeff Lee never was in Poland. Just. His last member was in Poland, LO2 was in Poland, Jeff Lynn was not.
Yeah. In Poland. Never in Italy.
No.
Never in Italy.
Such
I will go to Copenhagen to see it.
Many of our fan club members wanted to organize a concert.
Luigi powiedział, że tak samo jak w Polsce mam podobną sytuację. Jeff Lynn też ani razu nie był z koncertem we Włoszech. I coś mi się wydaje, że trzeba będzie zrobić jakąś zbiorową fuzję, żeby przyjechał i tu. Może jak dwa narody się zejdą, to wtedy będzie większe parcie. Jest godzina 19, wychodzimy właśnie z moją kuzynką Weroniką z miejsca spotkania z Luigi'm Lupollo. Bardzo przyjemne spotkanie, wymieniliśmy się prezentami, poglądami, tak jakby, i jesteśmy umówieni na piątkowy seans w jednym z kin w Rzymie, gdzie jednorazowo zostanie zaprezentowany po raz kolejny film Yellow Submarine, odrestaurowany cyfrowo w związku z 50-leciem jego premiery w 68 roku. Luigi jest niezwykłym człowiekiem, muszę powiedzieć. Wybitny kolekcjoner winyli, nienawidzi CD. Także no to jest człowiek Beatlesman z prawdziwego zdarzenia.
Znajdujemy się przed kinem Caravaggio przy ulicy Martini. Za chwilę rozpocznie się seans rocznicowej edycji Yellow Submarine. Obchodzimy 50 lat od premiery filmu. Bogata dzielnica, pełna ambasad. Prezes wita swoich ziomków.
Sì, un vinile giallo,
bravo, sì. Qui ce l'ho pure io.
Sì. Vabbè, questo si trova, no?
Sì. E me li riduce, va la cazzata.
Non costerebbe 20 euro se fosse...
Certo.
C'è solo Yellow Submarine,
eh? Vznowienie. Vznowienie singla winylowego. Picture disc.
Sì.
Z dwoma piosenkami, Ilene Rolligby i
Yellow
Submarine, które dzisiaj wyszło.
La maglietta di Abbey Road. Uh-huh. Presidente del Beatles Fan Club, ma Paul McCartney è morto o no? Qual è la scuola del pensiero dominante?
Assolutamente no.
È uscito un libro scritto dal segretario dal segretario del fan club.
Ma io non dicevo più cazzo, non dicevo più niente, non dicevo più che fa niente. Ma non lo so, ma poi se non mi trovato lo capitavo vicino, l'avevo fatto.
Ma sarà?
Sì, perché ho detto a lui.
Questo c'è. Placacic.
No, aspetta, non mi serve.
Io una volta non ho fatto prima di farne a me, perché...
Maurizio, aspetta a fare la volta.
Lavoro casa, è impossibile.
Luca, dai.
Sì, andiamo.
C'è la foto.
Ah! Ah, sì.
No, chi ce la fa?
Taki kącik w domu, to każdy by chciał. Proszę bardzo, oryginalny plakat filmowy Yellow Submarine z 1968 roku w wersji włoskiej.
Belle, sane,
Znajomy widok.
In cabina potete vedere i quattro Beatles che osservano tutte le proiezioni che noi facciamo. Due dei tre soci di questo cinema sono dei ferventi credenti della religione dei Beatles. Si doveva chiamare questo cinema Imagine, poi per tutta una serie di motivazioni l'abbiamo mantenuto con il nome originale di Caravaggio. E nel momento in cui è arrivata questa offerta dalla Universal, che mi ha mandato una mail con il marchio Apple e con il logo dei Beatles originale, non potevo fare altro che dire di sì, stampare questa mail e mettermela in cornice. Questo evento è fatto per l'anniversario, per la pubblicazione dell'edizione restaurata di Yellow Submarine, che tra poco vi proietteremo. Oggi è una giornata un po' particolare, come Luigi mi insegna, è l'anniversario dell'incontro. Oggi è il 6 luglio, è il 6 luglio del 57, i Beatles, anzi, Paul e John si incontrarono per la prima volta nella chiesa a Walton, mi sembra, e fu il primo incontro dei Beatles, oggi alle 7 di 61 anni fa. Ma sono tante le casualità che girano su questo film.
Sai come John Lennon rimase colpito da Paul McCartney? John Lennon non sapeva prendersi il settima, Paul McCartney l'ho preso in un attimo, lui rimase colpito da questa cosa, da parte di noi.
Poi qui c'è una miniera di informazioni sui Beatles, se vorrete prima, dopo, durante la proiezione, vi potete chiedere di qualunque cosa, qual era il numero dell'autobus che portava Paul a scuola dove incontrò il giovane?
Giriamo.
Ah, vabbè, più o meno siamo lì, era il numero 8. In questa sala potrete apprezzare e chiedere informazioni su di un quadro che è stato fatto da un artista contemporaneo che si firma Brivido Pop. Il quadro è qui all'ingresso della sala e resterà esposto fino a Natale, poi spero che vada a casa mia, ma non credo che più l'artista ve lo dia.
Ok, io do il come presidente dell'ufficio Beatles Fan Club Pepper italiano, do il benvenuto a tutti i fan polacchi e sono molto contento che proprio stasera abbiamo fatto un gemellaggio tra il nostro fan club e il tuo fan club, caro Michael, di Lublino. Sono molto contento di questo.
Raz, dwa, trzy, jedziemy do domu! Oh, I can't sleep at night, but just the same.